The strike of a Malayan pit viper slowed down 20 times. If you blinked, you'd miss it. This beautiful snake is a Malayan pit viper that I found crossing a road in Ganchanaburi province. I've brought it back to my house. This is not in the wild now. This is in a large room that I have where I'm able to release snakes in order to study them for a short time and film and photograph them before returning them to where I found them. Look at that pupil. Tiny slit of a pupil there, and then just in front of the eye, a pit, a heat sensing pit, with the nostril further forward at the snout of the snake. These snakes will eat mice, lizards, and frogs, so not only warm-blooded animals, as I previously thought. Frequently, I found them in this kind of style or attitude, with the head sloping upwards, sometimes almost vertically upwards. Perhaps that's the best way for them to pick up the heat that's coming from any animal in the environment around them. These snakes typically reach 70 to 90 centimeters in length. Females lay eggs and actually guard those eggs as well. This is one of Thailand's more highly venomous species of snake. They're typically found in overgrown farmland, plantations, etc. I've found them alongside abandoned rubber plantations and also, as in the case of this one, on the road next to a teak plantation. This species is found in several Southeast Asian countries, as well as a few other countries such as Nepal. Here, now later on in the morning, it has started to go under one of the logs that I've put into the room to provide a bit of cover. Typically a nocturnal species, but they will come out sometimes if it's a cloudy or rainy day during the daytime. Scenting a bit there with the tongue. I am in the room, of course, with the snake. I've set up carefully and quietly to one side, trying not to move too much. But now this viper has picked up my movements, because I've been very surprised to find that I've probably been standing on this little gecko. It has shed its tail. I've brought a bunch of leaves with me into the room to help decorate the floor of this room, and it would seem that I've either touched this lizard or brought it in with those leaves, or I've been stepping partially on it, and now it has gone under a bamboo leaf right in front of the snake. Oh, that's extraordinary. It appears to have no awareness at all that this viper is there. Look at that, good gracious. And then the strike. Incredible. That is a very lucky gecko. The snake has missed it completely. Now, it was obviously so fast, I don't have slow motion filming, and I wasn't prepared for such an incident anyway with this. So let's just have a look at it frame by frame. I've isolated 6 frames from the film. This is the last frame where everything is normal before the strike. There's the first frame of the strike. Look at that. I'm filming at 25 frames a second. So that has happened in 1/25th of a second. The mouth is open. There is the second frame of the strike. The fang is out, extended forwards in its sheath, the longest fang of any venomous snake in Thailand. the third frame of the strike, and it's already folded that fang back in, and the mouth is starting to close. It's gone over the top of the back of the gecko. The gecko now on its way out. This is the fourth frame of the strike, and we can still see there's movement there. The head of the snake is a little blurred, but it's returning to its original position, and there it is now, back at rest. So the entire action took just 4 frames out of 25 in a second, 1/6 of a second. Quite incredible. And here it is with the best slow motion I can produce with the equipment that I filmed it with.